Hey there, I'm Linda Cromar. I'm coming to you from my home office in Colorado. And as the title says, we're going to talk about the good, the bad, and the ugly about the autoresponders. What you need to know about them and why I've made the decisions I have. First of all, of course, I like to get on Facebook so that I can make sure that the audience gets to see this firsthand. And we'll go from there. I hope you're having an awesome Monday. Of course, Monday is my favorite day, actually. A lot of people have these feelings like it's not a fun day, but if you're working full time, I can understand and sympathize. I haven't had to work at an actual job for over 10 years, partly because my husband had a good income, but also because I started to build my own income and did not have to go and work for someone else. And that is one of the things that you must be willing to work hard for. That means sacrifice. That means working your butt off. It is not it's not just magic. It's not just you say it and then you do nothing. It's not you buy a program and then sit back and watch as nothing happens. You have to actually take some real effort towards the process. And that's what I want to share with you. That's also true when it comes to working with autoresponders. So I'm going to go ahead and share my screen. While I'm waiting for this to come up, and for some reason it's pretty slow. I hope I should not have a problem. It's still saying it can't stream. I don't know what that is. I might have to check and see what's going on with that. But anyway, we'll just go ahead and go into Traffic Wave. One thing I wanted to point out to you, that if you have suddenly stopped hearing from me on AWeber, that is because I closed down AWeber completely. I did a video about why I was going to do that last week. And I'm not building two or three autoresponders. There's no purpose in doing that. And as I've said many times, I have Power Lead System, but I use Power Lead System as mainly my contact database, not as my main autoresponder. It's not really constructed to do that very well. It's really more a great way to talk to people personally if they're on that list and they do have to go through the same process as they do with an autoresponder. They need to opt in willingly. You cannot add people. Most places are not good about letting you just add them in. So the good and the bad and the ugly about autoresponders, and of course I'm looking at the back office of TrafficWave. First off, AWeber is set to charge you basically every 500 subscribers. It jumps about $20. Now that can very quickly end up being $100 or more a month you're paying only for that one service, and not, you know, even irregardless of all the other things you might be using and paying for. And so I made the decision, not that I couldn't pay for it, but most of the people that are connected with me are newbies or people that don't have a large amount of budget. And they find it difficult then to actually be able to build an online presence with something that costs that much. They need low cost, yes, yet quality tools to help them build their business. So I started looking. It was about 6 weeks ago, I guess it was now, that I started looking at all of the other services out there. Most of them were built exactly the same as AWeber, that they charge you by how many subscribers, and then they charge you also for the tracking and all of that. So then it ends up being at least $100 a month for most people, and that's not counting anything else you might be spending some of your budget on that goes towards your online budget that you need to build your business. TrafficWave only charges $17.95 per month, flat fee, not based on your subscriber count. They do not charge you for how many campaigns you send. They do not charge you for anything else. And now they have a really cool commission plan as well. Already started to make money with it. That's not what this is about. I'm not trying to sell it to you, but that is the background of why I made the decision to change to TrafficWave as my autoresponder. Now, if somebody has a great big huge list in AWeber, they obviously are not going to close that down. But I had the option of making that choice because my list wasn't real large and because I noticed that a good part of that list was dead and did not appear to be real interested in actually opening my emails. I was getting an open of 1 point something pretty much all of the time, which is very, very low. You want to get up to 4 to 5 usually, and I'm starting to see that here, even though my list is small. I also decided to actually promote TrafficWave itself as one of my streams, and so I even have some, I've done some traffic towards it already, and I am going to do a lot more. So that's really just the background of why I made the decision and why I'm in TrafficWave now. And so when I come over here to what's called the Campaign Manager, now realize that campaign, the way TrafficWave looks at it, a campaign is a list that you have specified for a certain kind of program that you want to share with them, and then you want them to come over and be part of what you have going on. So one of the things I'm going to show you today is also that I'm going to start deleting out all of the extra autoresponders that I have in here, and the reason why is going to be that I want them to actually experience my personal contact with them more so than a lot of pre-written things, a lot of which I haven't written. So the only thing that really has to happen when you build your list in your campaign, say like if I look at this first one, this basic reset, which is my health program I'm part of, if I go to that list and look inside, I will see that if I go to the letters, that I only have one letter in here. And that one letter says, hey, welcome to my basic reset page. And I didn't actually tell them I want that to be. What you want to do is make sure that it actually goes up here to the days of delay. But in my page, if I go back here and I actually click on it and then edit it, just so that you can see the inside and what I wrote, I didn't do a whole lot of sales here. What I did is basically told people how they get started, what you can do, and I probably should have a link in here. And this is mainly going to be for if somebody is a customer to my to this. So, and I'm just telling them what to look at and how to get started inside of Basic Reset. And that's all I'm doing in there. And if somebody joins that list, this one's new, so there may not be anybody in here yet. When people join this list, they are going to immediately jump right over to my network, to my newsletter list. And the reason why I'm putting them in the newsletter list right away is because I'm not going to do a whole lot of sales, but one thing that is kind of cool that you can do, if I go back to just managing my campaign so you see all the lists, is that at any time that I want, I can send what's called a broadcast to any of the lists or all of the lists. You'd have to do it separately because that's how this is laid out. But that helps me make it that these people are getting mainly real contact from me, not from pre-written emails. You know, it used to be that you could grab somebody else's work and it was great because their expertise and their what they call copywriting would help you sell a product towards that situation. That's not the case any longer. You really have to be personable with people, writing from your own heart, from your own thoughts, and not trying to write like someone else, and it would be quite obvious when you do that. And another thing that I do that's very, very important is that it's called campaign chaining. And when I do that, that's basically telling them where that individual is supposed to go after they finish the the emails that are in that campaign. And as you can see, I've got all of them set up that they're going to go over to the newsletter, except for this one, and I'm going to really have to get all of them changed. They all go to the newsletter. None of them go anywhere else. And that's what I need to do for all of them. So this one here, I don't want this doing this. So what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to delete that one and create a new one. So I actually want the ILP, Two Power Lead System, to go over to the newsletter sooner. So I'm going to go ahead and make that one. And that makes that one go directly there instead of going, because I really want all the leads to end up in one place instead of being spread out through all of these campaigns. And then what I'm doing with this is creating kind of a funnel effect where they're going to start out because of something they're interested in, and then they're going to eventually end up on the newsletter list. But in the newsletter list, I will talk about all of the things I have in these other campaigns, so they can have the opportunity to find out again if they want to. But they'll find out again because I'm going to spend the time showing them why I believe it's important and what I think about it personally, and probably on video as much as possible, either in a blog post or a Facebook post. And they're going to find out more about what I'm interested in and why I'm sharing certain things based on my own personal testimony about that product or about that service. And that's why I'm going to put them just one or two letters, or they call them letters, you know, autoresponder messages or letters. I'm going to be just making it a lot less. I'm actually going to go in and delete some of these letters that I have in here right now. So I'm going to come back to the main list. And I'm just going to run in and go to the one that's called default. And these I actually did not write myself. So that's even the more important reason why I don't really want to have these letters in here now. I'll have maybe a few, but I'm not going to have a whole bunch of them in here. And so I'm going to especially delete out. So you can actually click here and hit the delete key. And then it asks you, do you really mean that? And you say, yes, I really mean that. And then it's going to take it off. And I'm going to start from the bottom and delete just mainly all of these, except for just maybe a couple, because I want them to actually get in the newsletter faster. I don't want them to spend too long out here. I find that a lot of people end up in unsubscribing a lot faster if they get a whole bunch of these newsletters. So I'm going to close out these. I'm going to only choose a couple that I think are particularly good. This one's good. I'm not going to have this one. And then I'm going to probably delete a lot of these. So I'll go ahead and keep that one. I don't want this one. And some of these don't make sense to me, actually. I'm not sure why they're in here. I'm just going to get rid of just a few. I'm not going to make this completely nude, but I'm going to get rid of the majority of them. And then one thing I'm also going to do is I'm going to make this one two, just so that I can put one in front of it that is my personal welcome letter, basically. And it's not doing it. See, I already did one right here where I sent out a newsletter. So what I'm going to do now is this one says 2 on it. I'm going to go and create a new one that's going to be a personal email to them so that they know that it's not just letters that someone else wrote. And another reason why you want to do it this is you don't want people to think that it's just someone else wrote it and I copied them. And it used to be that was okay. It's not okay anymore. So as you can see, I've already got a newsletter started here. All I have to do is now write a new one. This one's about a training, so I'm not going to do that. So I'm going to say, welcome to Traffic Wave. Hey, it's Linda. Open up. Okay, so that's kind of going to get their attention. Want to do something that does that. And then, of course, all of this inside part is not going to be correct, so I got to get rid of it. Okay, so I wrote, hi, I saw you opted in and maybe took the trial. Welcome. I want to give you a hey, how are you, and let you know I am here at any time. You can just hit, I'm going to put just, you can just hit reply and ask a question. I will always respond. And then my name, and this is my own salutation I use all the time. Now, you notice there's no links. You notice I'm not doing any selling. I'm just telling them that I'm interested in them because I've got a whole bunch of, I've got some new, what's called a co-op going out, 3 shares in a co-op that's going out in a few, probably about a week or week and a half, 2 weeks from now, whenever they do it. It's for May. And so this is going to be important. They're probably going to see this. So I want them to see this. And so now that's going to be number one. So you need to save it. And so that shows up on the bottom right now. So I need to, first off, this needed to be 2 and it didn't save for some reason. So we need to save that. So I'm actually going to make, this one's the 0. So this is the one that's going to be the first one that's going to show up in my email series here. And also notice I'm not going to have these every day. So this one needs to be 6. And this one needs to be 8. So it's going to be just a total of 8 days in which they will see these before they'll be moved over into my network, to my newsletter list. So now I've saved this differently than the way it was. It's going to look a little bit more like my own autoresponder instead of something that I copied from someone else. That's really, really, really important. You want to make sure and do that. So, and then you want it to sound like it's really you talking, not somebody that you copied. This day and age, people expect people to be real. And if you are copying someone else's words, unfortunately, in this very transparent social media world, they are absolutely going to know that it's not your words. So it's very important that you actually do that. What's also going to happen, because I shortened these up, any leads that are in here are not going to be receiving all of the emails that were in there. And so if somebody was like on the one right before this one that is here, then they're actually going to be at the end of the email series, and they're going to be moved over into my newsletter list. And that's going to be my major objective, is to get them to move over there faster, sooner, so that they're more likely to actually stay on my list, because they're going to get more personal and more fresh emails, because broadcasts are done as something that you do all the right away, kind of on the moment. And you might schedule one a day ahead or 2 days ahead, but you're not going to do it, excuse me, you're not going to do it a whole bunch of, 30, 60, 90 days. You're not going to do that. That's what I'm sharing here today. It's just really important to actually keep this a lot more personable, a lot more exact, and just get in the habit when you're working with any autoresponder, not just Traffic Wave, to just plan on that you're going to create a new email on a daily basis. Maybe not Sunday, but the rest of the week. I try to do that pretty much 6 days a week, Monday through Saturday. That way they're getting something fresh, and then you're sending out information that they are going to be interested in hearing about. Like today, I'm probably going to do an email about the new Game of Thrones episode that just came out, and because there's some pretty interesting insights that I already found from that could be related to what I do in my business. Now, I know that sounds weird, but people like it when you talk about things that they might be interested in. There's a lot of fanship around Game of Thrones, so that's one of the things. Or there's things going on in the politics, there's things going on in your in the world, there's tragedies happening. There's all kinds of things that you could use to your own benefit. For instance, I just heard today that there was a lot of controversy around unions lately, because Kamala Harris is talking about trying to get rid of the right to work, which means that they would have to join that union or they don't get to get that job. And they actually changed that law in a lot of states. So you should be aware of that when it comes time to you doing your own voting, because that does affect your personal paycheck if you have to have a union in the particular work you do. If they force you to be on a union, regardless of whether you want to be or not, then that takes away some of your rights, and you want to make sure you're paying attention to that. There's all kinds of things like that going on in her world that you can actually use in your benefit in your marketing, because those things affect people's paychecks. Those things affect people's lives and their ability to work. And so you can use that as part of your marketing. People are a lot more excited and interested in listening to what you have to say if you are up on what's going on in our world. So that's what I wanted to share with you today. Take the time to look at what you have for emails. Don't just think that you're going to have a whole bunch of automated emails and that's going to actually turn people on to your product. What actually turns them on to what you're doing and what you're sharing is that you have passion and that you really care about people. You really care about your product. You really care that what you're doing is right and real, and you want them to be part of it because they can get a benefit from using that product. That is a lot more beneficial to do it that way, because people don't like to be sold, but they like to buy if they find a value in whatever it is they are buying. when you go shopping, whether it's on Amazon or whether it's at your local stores, you go shopping because you have a need. You have something that you need to accomplish with that product. And it could be as simple as, I need a new pair of shoes. But you need to be able to buy a pair of shoes. And you're going to buy a pair of shoes that you like, but also feel good to your feet. And they accomplish the process, whatever it is that you want to accomplish. You're not going to go buy a pair of shoes that are three sizes too small, because you can't even get them on your feet. And that is the same thing that happens with marketing, is that you need to make sure that you're actually satisfying a person's need that they are looking for. And one of their needs is to know that you are actually personable, that you actually care about them, themselves, that it's not just that you're trying to make them buy without even knowing who you are. For instance, when people get my emails, a lot of the time I get responses back. And when I get responses, I respond back to them. Unless they're just being absolutely nasty and they want to criticize just because they want to be mean. But if they have a real honest question and they truly want to know something, then of course I'm going to answer them, and the best I know how I'm going to answer them. And that is how you want to treat the people that are looking at your product. You want to give them the opportunity to buy, but you don't want to, this, you know, the days of just being able to automate everything is truly not really true. There's times when you can set things up where someone else does it for you, but it's not truly automated in the sense that no human ever touches it. That's just silly to expect that to be true. You want real interaction with your customers. You want to know that they actually like what you're selling, and that you're satisfying a need that they have. And that's part of why I shared what I'm doing here today with this autoresponder, is that yes, I'm going to have some letters in here, but you notice I cut it down to 5, and I did that on purpose because I want them to actually realize I'm a real person, I'm interested in them, and I'm going to be involved with them. So that's what I have to share with you today. I hope you have an awesome day. If you want to learn more about this program, I'm going to leave a link underneath this video that you can go and check it out. Don't just check it out and then leave it, and don't come back and tell me what you think. And I will be sharing this in Facebook later today as soon as it downloads, and I will be talking with you again soon. Bye for now.